Okay, so welcome everyone. Today we will discuss one more concept and one more question type that is coming in usually in CSIR NET. so there you will see some type of question like to determine whether the reaction, a decay process or a reaction, is conserved or not, or is allowed or forbidden, or something like you have to check whether strangeness is conserved or baryon number is conserved, or which among the equation is forbidden or which among the equation is allowed. Like, so we'll discuss something related to that today. Okay, so there are some questions like so before going directly to the question, I will discuss something. So we know there are particles, elementary particles. Okay, so among the elementary particles, we know there are basically we divide into leptons and hadrons. Okay, so the particles are, we divide them into hadrons and leptons, right? So these leptons are these are the composite particle, right? So these are the composite particles. They like if we'll divide these hadrons, then we'll get subatomic particles. Okay, so these are made up of, basically these are made up of quarks, made of quarks. Okay, and these are the fundamental particles. Okay, these are the fundamental particles. Like, so in leptons we got in among leptons we have electrons, okay, and we have neutrinos and we have antiparticles. Okay, so if I am considering leptons, along the leptons we will see there are three generations, leptons and their antiparticles. So we will have electrons first. First we have electrons, like these are electron denoted by E and having charge, negatively charged. Okay, and we have electron neutrinos, these are nu E, and we have similarly muons. These are muon and they are denoted by mu minus, negatively charged, and similarly muon neutrinos. Okay, and this is denoted by nu mu. Okay, and we have tauons. This is tau, and I have tau neutrinos. Okay, new tau, and they are among with their antiparticles. These are having antiparticles also. Okay, so antiparticles, we will get a bar here, like for this antiparticle of this I will get a bar over here. Okay, and for here I will get E plus, and for mu here I will get is antiparticle mu plus here. Okay, so the charge is minus one, here charge is plus one, and the new electron neutrinos have no charges. Okay, so charges, if I will consider charges, so charges for electron and muon and tauon will have charge q as 1 minus 1 minus 1 and minus 1. Okay, and for neutrino parts we'll get zero charge. For nu E and nu mu and nu tau will get charge equal to zero. They all have charge zero. Okay, and among the hadrons we have like baryons, and see, these are made up of subatomic particles which is known as quarks. Okay, so these hadrons, are divided into baryons and mesons. Okay, depending on the combination of or composition of the quarks. Okay, and these quarks, like we have these quarks like up quark, down quark, charge, charm number, and here's strange, and up, down, charm, strange, and we have one another top and bottom. Okay, up quark, down quark, and charge quark, strange, and top, bottom. Okay, these are the quarks. There are six type of quarks, and the composition of quarks makes the different type of hadrons. One is our baryons, and another is mesons. Okay, so these have two quarks. These mesons will have two. They have two quarks. Okay, like they will have up down or down down prime. Example. Okay, these are like this. The combination of mesons, and similarly for baryons, they have three quarks. Okay, like we'll get up down or up down down or with strange up down s. Okay, so combination of them, up down down, up down s. So there are three baryons are consisting of three quarks. Okay, so and these mesons are again classified into pions and pion and kaon. All right, so these pions, like we have plus and minus and zero, and here also k plus, k minus, and k naught. Okay, so these are depending on the charges, as they are made up of two quarks. So here up quark have charge plus 2/3, and down quark have charge minus 1/3, and they also have antiparticles. Okay, so and our s have charge minus 1/2. Okay, and they have also antiparticles, like antiparticles of them are up bar, down bar, charm bar. These are the antiparticles, and they have charges, like if you'll see the charges will be if up quark have charge plus 2/3, then up antiparticle will have charge minus 2/3. Okay, so now I hope we got basic idea about the antiparticles, elementary particles like hadrons. There are hadrons, there are leptons, and leptons are the fundamental particle, and hadrons are the composite particles. They are made up of quarks. Like if we'll break hadrons, we'll get quarks. Okay, so if we will break leptons, we'll get nothing. We'll get only those particles, because they are the fundamental particles, right? So, and these fundamental particles are nothing but electron, muon, and tau, and they are antiparticles, and they are neutrinos. Okay, electron, neutrinos, and they are antiparticles. They are leptons. Okay, and when we are coming to hadrons are the composite particles. They are made up of quarks, and there are our six type of quarks: up quark, down quark, charm, strange, top, and bottom. And as these hadrons are composite particles, if there are two quarks, they are mesons. If there are three quarks, they are baryons. So the composition of three quarks makes baryons, and the composition of two quarks makes mesons. Okay, so and again, mesons are like they are divided into pions and kaons, pi mesons and k mesons. Okay, now we will see, and among baryons also we have proton, neutron, and there are lambda particles, there are sigma, there are zetas, there are omegas. They are under the baryons. Okay, so just we'll discuss how I will show you a table which particle have how much charge, what how much baryon number, and all. Okay, so to know a equation is conserved or not, we have to see whether the lepton numbers are conserved
and baryon numbers are conserved and the charge is conserved or not. If these three are conserved, a question becomes allowed. Okay, a question becomes allowed when baryon number, charge and lepton numbers are conserved. Okay, so see, we have leptons. So for checking lepton numbers, we have leptons like particles C, we have leptons, and for leptons we have electrons, okay, and its neutrino, and muons and its neutrino, and tauon and its antiparticle. Okay, so for this lepton numbers, like Le is the lepton number of electron, L mu is the electron lepton number for muon, and L tau is the lepton number for tau particle. Okay, so for this, see, for electron, electron lepton number is plus 1, and lepton number for muon is 0 here, and see here nu is the neutrino, electron neutrino, so for that the lepton number will be 1, and here 0. Similarly, for muon, the electron lepton number will be 0, and the muon lepton number 1, 0. Similarly for this also. Okay, so you have to remember these things, 0, 0, 1, because this is tau, 0, 0, 1, and this is neutrino for that one. And for this, our baryon number, see, as this is lepton, the baryon number will be 0 for this one. Okay, so baryon number is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 for leptons. Okay, and strangeness will be also 0 for leptons. Okay, so here leptons, and again if I will consider the mesons, we have pions. Okay, so pi plus will have lepton number 0, lepton number 0, lepton number 0, and baryon number will be also 0 for mesons. Okay, because these are mesons, these are not baryons. Okay, and strangeness will be equal to 0. But when we come into K plus, we'll have, there is also a strangeness number. Okay, we have to remember these things, and I will make the table and then I will discuss the problem. Okay, so this is like when we K plus, for K plus we have obviously lepton numbers will be equal to 0, and here baryon number also equal to 0, but this strangeness number is 1. Okay, similarly for K minus, here 0, 0, 0, and baryon number will be equal to 0, and strangeness number is minus 1. Okay, so if we'll K not consider, 0, 0, 0, 0, and here we'll get plus 1. Okay, so similarly these are the mesons. Okay, these are the mesons, and these are the leptons. And if I'll consider for baryons, okay, so here I will discuss baryons, and for baryons we have protons. Okay, I'm just giving the symbol proton. For proton, lepton number is obviously equal to 0, but baryon number is equal to 1, and strangeness is equal to 0. Similarly for neutron, this is 0, 0, 0, baryon number is equal to 1, and the strangeness is equal to 0. And next we will have lambda. This lambda is also a baryon. This is baryon, and lambda is equal to, lepton numbers are equal to 0, and this baryon number is equal to 1, and strangeness equal to minus 1 for lambda. Okay, you have to remember this table. Okay, then you can do all the problems related to this type of questions. Okay, so and you have lambda, and next we have sigma. Okay, sigma plus have 0, 0, 0 lepton number, and obviously lepton number is 0 and baryon number is 1, and just see the strangeness number here, minus 1 for sigma plus. And similarly for sigma minus, we'll get 0, 0, 0 and baryon number is 1 and minus 1. For sigma, we'll get the strangeness is if obviously as they are baryons, we'll get baryon number 1, but as only we'll see the strangeness number. The strangeness number for sigma is minus 1, then we'll get zeta, okay, this symbol, okay. For this we have we'll get 0, minus 1 and also plus 1 for this, okay. 0, 0, 0 and here we get 1 and this strangeness is minus 2. Similarly, another is there, that is just I am doing here. I hope you guys can see this, okay. Okay, sorry. Okay, so I hope you can see this. This is zeta and you get here 0, minus 1, plus 1, 0, 0, 1 and this strangeness is minus 2 for this symbol. And I will get omega. This is the value of omega. Omega minus is equal to 0, 0, 0, 1 and the strangeness for omega is minus 3. Okay, baryon numbers are 1. These are the baryons, these are the mesons and these are the leptons. Okay, I hope you guys understood this much. Okay, so and remember one thing, we have to check for the for a equation is allowed or not depends on allowed or not allowed. Depends on what? That depends on the baryon number and depends on, just a second, depends on baryon number, baryon conservation, okay, and lepton conservation and charge conservation, okay. See, just we have to remember this table and depend from this table I can determine all the equations which are conserved or not. Okay, so first I will go to the equation. Just give me a second, I'll do it here. Okay, let's see. So the equation, the question is to find out whether which among the following reactions are conserved. The question which was in the previous year net question, that is among the equation there are 4 equation. One is K dot is equal to mu plus mu minus, just I will do it side by side, and next one is mu minus E minus plus gamma, and here 3 we have P plus pi minus. Okay, so see, the first question I have to check, what I have to check, I have to check the lepton number. See, here there are no electrons, so we don't have to check the electron lepton number, so I will check the muon lepton number. So for the left hand side, the muon lepton number is, this is a meson, so lepton number will be equal to 0, K meson, and for right hand side, for this the lepton number, this is the antiparticle, so for antiparticle lepton number will be minus 1, and for particle this is the mu minus, for this the lepton number is 1, so I this lepton number satisfied, this is conserved. Next we have to check what? Next we have to check the charge. So the charge for left hand side, the charge is here 0, and for right hand side this is plus 1 charge, this is minus 1 charge, so this is also satisfied. And next we have to check the baryon number. See, this is the meson. For meson, the baryon number is 0 because meson is not a baryon. And next, these are the leptons. And for leptons, we have baryon number 0. So this is satisfied. Similarly, we can check for all the another equation is there. Similarly, we can check the equation, these lepton number, charge and baryon numbers for the rest of the 4 equations, okay, rest of the 3 equations. So this will be the answer. Okay, you guys can check this. Okay, next just I will give you for the practice, I will take 1, 2, 1, 3 examples. So let's discuss. This is the CSR question, CSR net question. Okay, and I am just showing you some examples so that you can just get some more knowledge and practice. So like we have a new mu, this is the muon electron. There are equations like this, plus just nu mu plus p equal to mu plus plus n. Okay, this is the equation. So just we have to check whether this equation is allowed or forbidden. Okay, so first of all we have to check, check the lepton number. So see, these are muons, so we don't have to check the electron lepton number. So I mean directly going to check the muon lepton number. So for this, this is nu mu, and for this the electron, so muon lepton number is plus 1, and this is a baryon, so for proton is a baryon, and for this lepton number is 0, and here this is a muon, and for this the lepton number is 1 plus 0. Here this is the antiparticle, for this will be minus 1. So this is here the lepton number is not conserved. So this equation is forbidden, right? So no need to check further. For the practice I can check the other things. So for charge, this will have zero charge, because and neutrinos have zero charge, plus here proton have charge plus 1, and here this is a mu plus, so the charge is plus 1, and for neutron the charge is 0. So this is satisfied, but this is not satisfied. And for baryon number, if I'll check, baryon number for this is 0, and this proton have baryon number 1, and this is baryon number for this is 0, and baryon number for this is 1. Okay, so this satisfied, but this as lepton number is not satisfied, this reaction is forbidden. Okay, similarly I can check one more equation. Okay, so yes, you guys can practice such equations or such reactions, because such type of questions are coming in the CSIR net questions. Okay, and you will get, like, here strangeness number is there, here baryon numbers are there, so you will get questions whether the baryon number is conserved or not, where the strangeness is conserved or not in a particular equation. Okay, so if you will remember this table, you can do all the problems related to the reactions, like whether equations are conserved or not, whether something is conserved or not. You can attend this type of questions. Okay, thank you.